Today in Matters of Fact, President Rodrigo Duterte has accepted an apology from ABS-CBN for airing a political ad in 2016, showing children raising questions over his foul language and questionable antics during the campaign. But he did not say whether he's now in favor of renewing the broadcast franchise of the largest media network in the Philippines. In the meantime, bills to keep the network on the air for another 25 years are not moving in the House of Representatives. Joining us today is Bayan Muna Representative Carlos Zarate. Good morning, sir, and thank
Good
you for
morning,
joining
Christian.
Us. Okay, there was a statement coming from the president last night. Finally, he said he was accepting the apology from ABS-CBN. And then when he was asked whether he would finally support or if he would support a franchise renewal, he said he would cross the bridge when he gets there. Now, when we spoke with some of your colleagues in the lower house, they were quite blunt in admitting that many of them were waiting for signals from the president. Do you think with this fresh statements from the president, these could finally get things moving in the House?
Yes, I think that's a good signal, no? Because if you recall, what started this issue was the rant of the president that in the 2016 election, there were ads that were not aired, no? At sabi niya galit siya sa ABS-CBN. That is the reason I think why even in the 17th Congress, these bills calling for the renewal of the franchise of ABS-CBN's franchise did not move, no? So here we are now, tawagan nila nito ultima hora, no? The clock is very fast ticking until May 4. So that signal, I think, was a welcome signal from Malacañang to finally convince the leadership of the House, especially the Legislative Franchise Committee, to keep the bills going in the legislative mill by conducting a formal hearing.
But in the meantime, there's no formal hearing yet. The most that the Committee on Legislative Franchises began was to accept position papers. And do you still have time to actually pull this off before the break?
We still have six session days until March 11. No? So, tingin ko, if there is this strong push for the leadership of the House to finally set this hearing, we can do that. No? But in the meantime, we have to look for some alternatives, no? To be ready with some alternatives, because May 4, that's also the day that we will be resuming our session. That's also the last day of the franchise of ABS-CBN. Mm.
Now, yesterday, I was speaking with Congressman Raul Del Mar, and then we asked him, well, actually, who or what exactly was the reason behind the delay on why the bills were not moving? He said it's not exactly the president, but it's the speaker himself.
Well, the leadership of the House has said that there are some priority bills, no? But kung titingnan mo yung mga hearing naman sa Legislative Franchise Committees, no? Calling for renewal of franchises of other entities or application for new franchises, napakabilis naman itong kumilos doon sa committee. So, there might be some other reasons, no? But again, the unwritten reason for that, I believe, was really the call of the president before, no? Na ayaw niyang ma-renew yung franchise ng ABS-CBN, no? That he will stop the renewal of the franchise. But again, as I've said, this is a good, what he said yesterday was a good signal, no? And I think the lower house should take cue from that statement of the president.
If that's the case, won't that make the lower house look more of a rubber stamp? That just because the president sent this new signal, your colleagues would now start acting when in fact they're supposed to be independent?
Well, that's an additional push, no? Because whether you like it or not, that's the, I think, the unwritten reason there, no? Although there are statements from the leadership of the house that there are priority bills, like they prioritize the tax bills, no? And the other measures. But I think dapat ding bigyan ito ng priority, no? Because this has already become not just an issue between ABS-CBN and Congress, but it has become a people's issue, especially what happened in the past days.
Okay, and we also have on the line the President's spokesman, Secretary Salvador Panelo. Good morning, sir, and thank you for joining us.
Well, good morning.
Okay. I'd like you to respond to that observation that according to Congressman Zarate, it seems to be that that was the unwritten reason why the bills of ABS-CBN's franchise renewal were not moving. It's because of the president's concern. Now, with the statements given by the president yesterday, is it correct to see this as a good signal for the House of Representatives to finally get moving?
I disagree with the view that the statement of the president has something to do or anything to do with his grant or renewal of the franchise. I've repeatedly said, and the president repeatedly said too, that his personal feeling on the matter, especially with respect to the fraud created against him, has nothing to do with the grant or renewal of the franchise. You must remember, Christian, that this application for a renewal has been filed even during the presidency of Pinoy. And the previous Congress did not tackle it. So I cannot even understand why they keep on dragging the name of the president in this issue.
Because
the incident between him and ABS-CBN is a different thing from the grant or renewal of franchise. Now, you tell me that the members of Congress are waiting for a signal. I'm begging your pardon, but members of Congress should not and must not be waiting for any signal coming from the president or intimidated or influenced by any statement of the president. Otherwise, they have no business being members of Congress. Look at Mr. Zarate. He's not influenced by Mr. Duterte's any statement. He's standing on his own. Why can't other members of Congress do that?
Of course, it's a precedent to actually give those statements against ABS-CBN in the past. So if you speak with many of the leaders of the House of Representatives, that they would say that since those statements came from the president, they carried a lot of weight. And you know, the reality is in Philippine politics, the president is very strong under a presidential system that he actually gets to control the lower house specifically.
No, that was probably, you may be right, Christian, with respect to the reality of previous administrations. Because the reality of today's politics with presidents being there is different. I think that Congressman Zarate knows that the nominees of the president did not pass the Commission on Appointments. If you're talking of reality before that the president controlled Congress, he never interfered with the work of Congress. You didn't hear any utterances of complaint, disgust, or displeasure when his nominees were bypassed by Congress, were disapproved by Congress.
So what do you think is the reason why the franchise bills are not moving in the lower house? It's not because of the president?
You should ask members of Congress, not me.
Yeah, but from where you're sitting, how do you see that?
I really do not know, because it's Congress. Members of Congress who are supposed to do that, it's their job. They should not be influenced by any outside factor. Cannot even understand why they're not doing their work.
Okay. Now, there's certain moves coming from the Senate and the House of Representatives to actually pass a joint congressional resolution that would make sure that ABS-CBN would remain on the air while this franchise renewal bills are being heard. Now, we know that a joint resolution would actually go up to Malacanang for the president's signature. Would the president support that, at least to make sure that the network would remain on the air during the pendency?
Christian, joint resolution does not need signature of the president. Second, a joint resolution is not binding. It's not binding like a law. If they can pass a resolution extending the franchise, why can't they not pass a law? Because the resolution requires only a majority vote, and the passage of a law requires the same. So what's stopping them from passing a law?
Yeah, that's a valid point. That I would like to clarify that what I'm talking about is a joint congressional resolution, not a concurrent resolution.
A what?
Concurrent resolution, which won't require the president's signature, but what I was referring to was a joint congressional resolution.
Because I cannot understand what you're saying. So your voice fluctuating. Anyway.
Okay. So in this case, so your position is that the Congress should just do its job and keep the president out of this. My next question is regarding this. There are those who say that it's actually the president who influenced the Solicitor General's move to file a co-warranto petition. Now, last night, the president said that he was basically stopped since the Solicitor General has already spoken. Now, in this case, my final question is regarding this. Do you think the doctrine of qualified political agency doesn't apply here, that this Solicitor General did not act?
The doctrine of what?
A qualified political agency, that the Solicitor General did not exactly act as an alter ego of the president in this particular co-warranto petition?
No, it will not apply. You must remember that the Solicitor General has a constitutional task, and he's just functioning his duty. He's doing what the Constitution tells him to do and what the law says he should do. I've been saying repeatedly that the president is starting to use the call warrant. And I even asked the sergeant about that. And I was filing a petition for call warrant. And he told me that because I discovered certain violations. And when I asked him, why only now? Because there's only now that I discovered. And why are you still filing it when supposedly the renewal, the expiring is forthcoming? And he said, well, if I don't do this, and I'll be charged with the election of duty. That's his position. And he...
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Secretary Salvador Panelo, for responding to our questions this morning.
Thank you, Christian.
Okay. So you heard the statement coming from the president spokesman. So basically, you cannot get any clearer than that when it comes to making sure that the House specifically would do its job in this particular issue, but that he mentioned joint resolution. What's your position in that? Well, that, of course, that would require the president's
very clearly under
signature.
The rules.
Yeah.
You know, a joint resolution is just like a bill, you know, that has to get the imprimatur of the president.
I think he confused that with the concurrent resolution, which does not require the president's signature.
Yeah.
But my point is this. Does that actually ensure that while the bills are being heard regarding franchise renewal, that would be enough to keep the network on the air? A joint resolution.
A joint resolution, even a concurrent resolution, just to express the sense of the House. My opinion on that is the Congress, especially the House of Representatives, and in particular the Committee on Legislative Franchise, in the exercise of our residual power, you know, we can, you know, direct, for example, or express our intention to the National Telecommunications Commissions that in the meantime that we are hearing this particular franchise bill, you can do your duty by continuing your issuance of permit, no, even a provisional permit for, in this case, ABS-CBN.
But what is the basis of that?
Well, there was this...
What is the legal backbone of that?
The Committee on Legislative Franchise has the primary jurisdiction, no, to look into the application for franchise and renewal of a franchise. No? So in the exercise of its residual power, no, it's not written in the Constitution, but part of its power, no, of looking into the validity or the of the validity of the issuing or renewing a franchise, then it can direct agencies, no, tasked to perform administrative functions like NTC.
So you don't need the approval of the entire Congress, even the committee can just direct the NTC?
Yes, because there was a precedent before, no, and for as long as this precedent is not superseded, I was referring to that memorandum of understanding in 1994, entered into by the Committee on Legislative Franchise, the National Telecommunications Commission, and the KBP. You know. Although some said are saying that is no longer applicable, but if you read the that MOU as well as the memorandum circular issued by the NTC thereafter, you know, it appears that they're using this, you know, to really extend the operation of an entity pending the renewal of or approval of a franchise. No? Mm. So in this case, as I have said, the franchise of ABS-CBN is until May 4.
No? Is it actually May 4 or March 30?
No, because it was published
15 days before May 4.
May 4.
1995.
So even the reckoning now is May 4. No? So I've said that my opinion on this, before May 4 lapses, no, NTC should have already issued a provisional or temporary permit for ABS-CBN to continue. No? As in fact, I think this was the thinking also of the leadership of the House. No? Yesterday, the Committee on Legislative Franchise, with the conformity of the Speaker, wrote NTC saying that it can issue a provisional authority to ABS-CBN from after May 4 of 2020 until such time that the Congress can pass or renew the franchise of ABS-CBN.
Now, if the day of reckoning now is May 4, not March 30, would that be enough for, let's say, the lower house and the Senate to actually finish the job?
I think, as I've said, we still have 6 session days.
No? Even in 6 days, you can finish this?
Last week, we have a hearing in the Committee on Legislative Franchise. 3 franchises were approved, no, by the House, and it was immediately referred to the Senate on the same day. Mm. So if there is really that big push, no, to hear these 12 bills now pending with the Committee on Legislative Franchise, I think we can do that. No?
So if that was a statement from the President last night, if that was the statement this morning coming from the spokesman of Malacanang, so what's keeping the House leadership from moving faster here?
Well, based on the statements of the leadership of the House, no, there are other priorities. No, but for now, the ball is already rolling with the acceptance or reception of these position papers. But again, as one of the authors of the pending bills, we believe that the issues have already been laid down. No, the issues are already clear. No, and it's not that complicated really, that we have to wait until June or until August. No?
Why did you say that somehow the issues have been laid out already? Are you referring to the Senate inquiry last Monday, where a lot of issues were discussed?
That's
but of course,
true.
Your colleagues might also argue that, hey, that happened in the Senate. You would like to listen to those arguments here in our panel.
But to be candid, nakatulong yun, no? Para mapag-usapan yung mga issues na dapat pag-usapan. And it helps that that hearing was held, no, the Senate. So if we have 6 session days, sa tingin ko pwede namin, kung ano pa man yung gustong itanong ng mga kasamahan ko sa House, ay pwedeng malinawan doon sa 6 na araw na yan. So that pagbalik namin sa May 4, no, as I've said, last week we passed 3 bills, no? Na-refer ka agad yun sa Senate. Then the Senate will have enough time to also look into these bills. No? Mm-hmm. And possibly, pagbalik namin sa May 4, we have at least 1 month pa, no, to before we go on Sine-Jay adjournment. Then these issues can already be addressed.
Okay. Now let's talk about possible lessons that we can draw out of this experience. Of course, it's a bit early to actually talk about those lessons, given that the franchise renewal bills are still stuck in the committee level. But generally speaking, when it comes to, let's say, dealing with the broadcast franchises that are about to expire, how is there a way to somehow keep it away from too much politicking, from too much pettiness, for example, to make sure that the issue of press freedom and free expression won't be compromised too much, at least when you talk about renewing a franchise of any broadcast network?
Well, actually, the case of ABS-CBN is very unique, no? Because in the other franchises that were tackled by the Committee on Legislative Franchise, hindi naman ganito ka-controversial. For example, the renewal of the franchise of GMA, na delay rin yon, but they were allowed to operate, but there was no so much issue about it.
Yeah, but my point is, how do you keep, let's say, politicians from dipping their fingers too much into the affairs of actual journalism. And sometimes this can be used as, I'm speaking in general terms here. So this can, on principle, this can be used by politicians, let's say congressmen, for example, to blackmail a broadcast station. Sabihin, oh, during the campaign or during the previous years, you had been attacking me and then you're now applying for a new fresh franchise. So you see the how certain politicians would like to see that.
Well, ang tingin ko na for as long as that power is lodged, principally, no, doon sa political institutions ng ating system of governance, no, you cannot really avoid that, no. Talagang ginagamit yan. Now, what is important probably is kailangan palakasin natin yung other stakeholders outside of Congress, no? Kasi yung renewal ng franchise, while it is a prerogative of Congress, that power eventually comes from the people, no? So kailangan yung other stakeholders maging active din sa labas, no? Looking into these issues. Like I can see, no, as in my third term now in Congress, yung mga committee hearings ng legislative franchise are seldom attended to by other stakeholders, even by civil society organizations. No? But in the other committees, they are so very active. So isa siguro yun, no, to
so insulate. They have to be more engaged.
Yes, no. Because ito yung committee na parang ang bilis lang dumaan ng mga bills dyan. No, without scrutiny.
I think that is one thing I think that the public should understand, that in the past, there had been no issue regarding this. Now, for example, it's more of the focus was more on the technical aspect, right? But in certain cases, it seems that there's that temptation for certain politicians, let's say for certain legislators, to actually go into the content of what had been aired, for example, and use that against that company during the time when the renewal is up there.
Well, there's a trend now, Christian, to delegate all these powers to administrative agencies. For example, franchises on transportation, it was already fully delegated. You don't have to go to Congress to get a franchise. So there are some advocates that are saying that even on franchises of broadcast media should have been delegated fully na to the administrative agents.
Are you in favor of this?
Well, I think because ang pinag-uusapan talaga rito ay mga technical issues. If it can be delegated to an administrative agency, to a regulatory agency, then why not? No? Why go to Congress? No? For as long as Congress can maintain its oversight function over these agencies.
What's the advantage of that if you delegate that to an administrative or regulatory agency? Because here, technically the regulator, aside from Congress, is the NTC.
Yes. But again, there is no assurance, no, that pressures will not come. Either coming from those who are already with that agency, who is that agency is actually also controlled or under the direct supervision and control of the executive. So hindi mo rin pwedeng sabihin wala nang pressure, no? You can insulate this agency from politicking and pettiness, no? But ganun din, no? Pagdating mo naman sa ang Congress kasi ngayon, I think Congress should focus on more legislative measures that have more impact on our people, no? Instead of, I'm not saying na wala namang ginagawa ang Kongreso dito sa Committee on Legislative Franchise, no? But if it can be delegated, then why not?
Okay. Congressman Carlos Zarate, thank you very much for joining us. Thank you.